We have a brand new program on 1011 Strong. It's called QED. I would like you to meet Professor Quentin E. Deverell by name. We really call him Sam Waterston, though. QED stands for not only the initials of his name, Quentin
right.
Deverell, but...
Also.
But all, and also, and slash also, quod erat demonstratum.
There you go.
You will be quizzed right after 10:11 morning as to exactly what that means. Now, I think that's real fun. Did you come up? Who came up with that? Quod erat demonstratum.
Well, I don't know. You mean who thought of it
originally? Didn't math?
I
think mathematicians. What? What did
it's
you
been
say?
Around for years. I don't know who thought of it.
The mathematicians, I think.
Yeah.
Don't they,
they used to put it at the bottom of their proofs. That's where.
Yeah. It whenever they solved a story, a little mystery, or the puzzle, then they put QED. I love that.
That's exactly right.
A typically British, thing to do.
I think they even did it here for
a while. Did they, right?
Yeah. Yeah, I do.
Well, math is kind of an international language.
It is indeed.
The interesting thing about this show is the fact that it's produced by the same people, the BBC people, who did Upstairs, Downstairs on PBS and The Duchess of Duke Street. John
Hawksworth.
Hawksworth. How did you get involved? Why did they choose an American to play the role when everybody else is British, aren't they?
Well, no, there are two Americans in this.
Who
There's
else
another guy named A.C. Weary, and he and I are... We are the American contingent. Everybody else is.
Why did they choose an American, Sam? I mean, they could have gone with somebody British, could they not have?
I suppose they could. I don't know. I'm glad they picked
I'm
an American.
I'm very glad they picked you, or you wouldn't, have a job.
That's right. I'd be out of work.
You saw this guy 20 years ago on Broadway in Oh, Dad, Poor Dad, Mama's Hung You in the Closet, and I'm feeling so sad. 20 years ago on Broadway, Sam, you don't look that old.
Thank you.
That's all you're going to say about that? That's all you're going to say about that?
Well, I don't know what else to say.
Well, you have...
I do thank you, though.
Tell us about the show. Tell us about QED.
Well, it's an adventure story.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a comedy.
Mm-hmm.
And it's set in England in 1912.
Mm-hmm.
And it's about puzzles, solving puzzles. That's why it's
It's going to be a big budget show because the BBC frequently pays a great deal of attention to detail. Hot air balloons, ships, storms.
That's right, storms at sea.
Big budget. Did you go out on the sea to shoot that, or how did you do it?
Yes, we did. We went out on the sea, and then we also shot in a tub in the studio, you know, in a little basin of water. You know.
Yeah. Are you going to have a constant conflict with Mr. Kilkus?
Is that going to be a regular? There's going to be regular conflict with him, but not always.
Well, Kilkus is the bad guy, and this is the good guy.
Right.
And they're going. They have difficulties.
That's right.
In meeting their obligations.
No.
Yes.
In meeting their obligations.
Mm-hmm.
What do you mean by that?
Yours is not to question.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Sam Waterston has been around for a number of years, and he's going to be doing this show. There's only six in the series, six? Or will it be a continuing series, Sam?
It will be a continuing series if you and many, many other people like you watch it.
Well, we love the BBC, and that's had a very successful, Mr. Hawksworth has had a very successful run.
Yes.
How many shows have you shot thus far?
Six.
Just six?
Right.
Where's the seventh? Where's Lucky Seven?
That will be for next fall, if you agree.
Okay, now what can we do to get the viewers to watch this show?
Exhort them.
Exhort?
Yes.
Exhort our viewers?
Watch. Say, watch the show.
Well, now plead to them. Tell them. Tell them why it's a good show.
I've gone about as far as I'm going to go. They don't want to watch this show after all we've done.
You and I together,
honestly,
after all we've done, he's been in ships and hot air balloons, he's had to
right.
do all that,
soaking
just
wet
so you could
weather.
Enjoy this.
That's right.
Has it been worth it?
Yes.
Did they pay you well?
Oh, yes.
A lot of money?
Sure.
What do you do with all your money, Sam?
I save it.
For a rainy day?
That's right.
Do you tuck it away?
Yes.
Or do you invest?
Well, I don't know what I do, actually, with it. I save it. Mm. Yeah, I invest them. What do you do with your money?
I don't have any.
You don't have any money.
I got $4.
Come on.
I got $4.
You got $4?
I have $4.
Well, I don't even have $4.
Somebody's got it. I know somebody's got it. It should be an interesting show, I think. Great attention to detail. Great adventure. And he's a fine actor. He's won all kinds of awards, Obie Awards, Drama Desk Awards, Much Ado About Nothing. You saw him in Glass Menagerie. You also saw him in Heaven's Gate. What happened to Heaven's Gate, Sam?
What are you laughing about?
Well, I saw the original and it went on and on and on. And it was, I got the feeling that there was so much dust in the air in the theater because it was shot almost through a, like a big screen of smoke and haze and dust. I kept waiting for them to clear all of that out so I could see. It was almost like a sepia tone.
Ah, I kind of like that. You didn't like that, huh?
Well, I did, but there was a great deal of it, a great
quantity. There was. Well, it was a long movie, wasn't it?
Yes, it certainly was. Well, let's hope the QED is going to have a little more success in Heaven's Gate.
Oh, yes. Let us hope that.
You're a very funny guy.
So are you. Only you're not a guy.
How can you tell? How can you tell, Sam?
Well, you know, I'm a scientist.
Oh, that's true. That'll give you a little flavor of what this joker is all about. Sam Watterson, his name. QED is the program. I hope you'll be watching it here on 1011 Strong. Thank you, Samuel. It was
Thank
a pleasure.
You. For okay. me, too.
And 1011 Morning continues.